Very good morning, students. Welcome to the another session of irrigation and hydraulic structure subject. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the three types of spillways. One is straight drop spillway, oogie spillway, and a side channel spillway. Chute spillway also we have discussed. So these are the different types we have discussed. In continuation to the previous class, that is the types of spillways. Now today we are going to discuss about conduit or tunnel spillway. So what is this conduit or tunnel spillway? Where it is used? What are the different key features, prominent features of this conduit and tunnel spillway? Let us have a look at them. So if you see the conduit or tunnel spillway, so whatever the spillway we are using, it is in the form of a tunnel or in the form of a conduit. So where this particular type of spillway is used? Whenever there is an insufficient space for other types of spillways. It may be a oogie spillway, or it may be a vertical drop spillway, straight fall spillway, or else it may be a side channel or chute. So these are the different types are there till now we have seen. So if for them, if the space is not sufficient, adequate space is not there, then in that particular case we can go for this conduit or tunnel spillway. Okay, so this is a closed tunnel. So it is an inclined shaft, like inclined shaft it may be. So these spillways are designed to partly flow. So 100% flow is not expected. So partly flow of water is only expected here. So to ensure the free flow in the tunnel, so what we are doing, the ratio of flow area. So whatever the flow area is there, that flow area to the total tunnel area is often limited to only 75%. And also air vents must be provided there. So let us have a look at them, the symbolic picture. Now here the pictorial view of this conduit or tunnel spillway. So this is, let us assume this is our dam. So this is our crest of the dam here is here. Okay, so what we are doing, we are constructing a tunnel, as there is the sufficient space is not available for other types of spillways. So what we are doing, we are going for the tunnel spillway or conduit spillway. So at the upstream side like this, we are providing the tunnel spillway with an open inlet like this, and the tunnel is followed like this, and after that it is bent like this, then afterwards a straight horizontal tunnel is given and which is directly connected to the downstream of this dam. So whenever the excess water is there, so all the water will be coming here. Whenever excess water will be there, the water will be flowing into the tunnel and it is passed towards the downstream side at a safe rate. Okay, so here in the picture you can see, so this is the reservoir. So in this reservoir the water is there. Now currently the water is at below this conduit level. So whenever water level increases, what happens? The water is try to flow towards this tunnel, and this inlet outlet of the tunnel will be somewhere here. So this will be, water will be provided to the downstream, passed to the downstream side at a safe rate. So this is an example of conduit, or we can call it as tunnel spillway. It is in the form of a tunnel. Okay, so this is designed for only a part flow, partly flow. So fully 100% flow is not expected, not designed for that. Okay, now let us go for the another type. Now here shaft spillway. So what is the meaning of shaft spillway? So previously we have seen it is an inverted type of shaft. So here directly we are using the shaft type of spillway. So here what we call it as, this shaft spillway is called as shaft spillway, or a drop inlet spillway, or else morning glory spillway. So any one of these gives the same type of spillway. So this is one which has horizontally positioned lip through the water enters the drop through the shafts. Like in the previous case where what we have seen, it is also a similar kind, but the structure is little bit different and it is given for 100% flow. So preferred when there is an inadequate space for the other types of shafts. Other types of spillways are having not suitable for them, it is inadequate space is available, so then we can go for this shaft type of spillways. So here the three main different elements are there in the shaft spillway, that is overflow control weir. So at the upstream side, so whenever the water is overflowing over the weir, so overflow control weir will be there, means a weir is placed to control the overflow, means at constant rate the water will be flowing into the shaft spillway. Okay, the second one is vertical control. So vertically we are providing such a structure that it should be controlled, the flow is not sudden, it is at uniform rate. Okay, and the last one is closed discharge channel. The shaft is completely closed to control the discharge in the channel. Okay, now let us have a look at the key elements here. So before that, let us take a few points. So if the shaft is small, what happens? They are constructed by metal or concrete alone, only with respect to these two. If the shaft is small, length is small and width and other dimensions are small. If the shaft is very large, vertical, then in that particular case it is constructed by RCC material, reinforced concrete only we have to consider. So sometimes what happens, we have to provide diversion works also, where some kind of upstream work is going on, then we can convert this diversion of water, so which is then afterwards the same diversion channel can be connected to the vertical shaft for the spillway type of construction work. So it is easy, both of them are connected, interconnected. Okay, so there are two types of shaft spillways are there. One is standard crest type and the second one is flat crest type. So what is this flat and standard? Let us have a look at them. So this is your, let us assume this is our dam, earth dam, let us consider. So overflow is not at all possible through an earth dam. So in that particular case what happens? So this is your spillway tunnel. So this is your tunnel plug. It is like this. So before this, what we are doing, we want to divert the water. So some work is going on. While the work is going on for this tunnel, what we have to do? Water should not enter here. So that is the reason we are constructing this diversion tunnel. Then after that, after completion of this work, this is connected to this spillway inlet. So this kind of plan can be adopted here. Okay, so this is top view and this is side view. Here you can see, so whatever the control weir is there, so this weir, so whatever this weir is there, that is allowing the water at safe rate. Okay, so after allowing the safe rate, this is the vertical control shaft and then afterwards it is horizontal control shaft. Okay, so here you can see the standard crest type shaft as well as flat crest type shaft. So coming to standard crest type shaft, here you can see this is the weir. So this is the weir in the second type, but here straight vertical fall will be there. There is no control weir is there. So direct free fall is there into the tunnel, vertical shaft. So here in case of flat crest type, what happens? Here we are providing a weir. Weir is provided like this, so that without entering the directly into the vertical shaft, water will be flowing through the weir and then it is falling here. So that is the difference between standard type as well as flat crest type. In flat crest type, we are providing additional section like weir section, where that is not there in the standard crest type. So that is the only difference between these two types. The remaining all the parts are same, like vertical shaft will be there, vertical shaft will be there, as well as this portion and this portion are same, except the difference is weir section is extra in flat crest type shafts. Okay, now let us go for the siphon spillways. So what is this siphon spillways? So this siphon spillways are work under siphonic action. We know, we might have heard about siphonic action, siphon cross drainage works, siphon canals. So in the same action is same principle is used here. A siphon spillway is the one which utilizes the siphonic action to discharge the surplus water. So whatever the extra water is there, excess water is there, so that will be pumped away, or else passed away by the siphonic action. So what is the siphonic action? Let us have a look at that. So this siphon system consists of a closed conduit system formed in the inverted U shape. So whatever this is there, so that is forming an inverted U shape like this. So it is like this. So water will be collected from here and it is moving like this. Okay, so it is somewhere, it is like this. So this is the upstream side, so water will be collected from this and it is going like this. So it is a kind of inverted U shape. Okay, so in this, when the water in the reservoir level rises above, means we are assuming that this is the reservoir level. Okay, so this is the reservoir level, so just above this, the normal pool, so water flows over the crest and then siphonic action takes place. Means water will be entering here, then it is flowing like this, then siphonic action takes place. So there are two types of siphon spillways. One is saddle siphon, the second one is volute siphon. Let us quickly have a look at them. So what is saddle siphon? Saddle siphon, in that there are two types are there. One is hooded type and the second one is tilted type. So what is hooded type? What is hooded type? Hooded type is that, so this is the hooded type of siphon and the second one is tilted type of siphon. So in hooded type, what we are doing here, you can see this is the inlet of the siphon. It is like this. So here a cup is provided here. So this is the inlet of this premier. So whatever this inlet is there, this is our siphon. Okay, just above this we have a dip premier. So this dip premier is also another inlet which is just kept above the water level, pool level. Okay, whereas the main hood, whatever the main hood is there, that is kept submerged in the water, so that whatever the floating debris are there, floating particles are there, will not enter into this siphonic canal. Okay, so this is just kept above this, and these two, whatever this dip premier hood as well as this main hood is there, they are connected at the air inlet. So this is the air vent. So at this secondary or the premier hood as well as this main hood are connected here. So when, what happens whenever the water is entered in this, what happens whenever the water level rises up to this, so what happens, this will be locked, whatever the amount of air will be there, that will be locked here. So water is entering like this. So whenever this water along with this, whenever it crosses over this, what happens, then the immediately after touching this water to the downside lip, then what happens, immediately siphonic action will take place like this. So wherever this downward lip is there, this is also kept submerged in the water, because in the tail water it is submerged, because water, whatever the air is there at the downstream side, should not enter into the upstream direction. So this is also kept in water and this is also kept in water. So this is how siphonic action takes place, and the water will be flowing as a from the spillway through the siphonic action. And this siphonic action breaks at some place whenever the water level is below the reservoir level. Then what happens, so water level will be, let us assume it is here, so there is no water here, so it is, the siphon is completely filled with air, so then the siphonic action breaks. Whenever the water is completely filled in the siphon canal, then only the siphonic action will be continued. Then when the water level is below the reservoir level, then air will be entering into the siphon, then there will be a breakage of siphon action, will be broken. Okay, so this is also tilted type. Okay, so here this is hooded type and this is tilted type. So inlet and mouth of the main hood are kept submerged in the water to avoid debris, as well as a small dip premier hood is kept above the main. So that is also discussed. Okay, so lower lip is kept. So here two actions are important. One is priming and the second one is depriming. So siphonic action is established, already discussed. Siphonic action will be established. So whenever the air in the vent over the crest has been exhausted, so whatever the water is, air is there, if that is exhausted, then it is completely filled with water, then we call it as, that is a priming action. Okay, so whenever during flood recede, during receding flood means there is no water, water level is below the reservoir level, then what happens? Water level has gone down the below the reservoir level and then air enters into the deprimer. Okay, so then siphonic action is broken. So this action is called as depriming, whereas this one is called as priming. Okay, so there are several types of priming devices which fasten the priming action, because through the priming action only the water is passed from upstream side to downstream side. So it is required to fasten the priming action. So for early priming in spillways, so these are the seven different types of provisions are there as priming devices. The first one is provision of a cup type basin. So just now we have seen, so this is provision of tilted outlet, provision of auxiliary or baby siphon, so provision of tudal or step type of provision of step just after the crest, and also provision of hinged adjustable plate. The next one is provision of priming weir. So these are the several types of this one. So this is a tilted type where it is, this action is taking place like this, and this is the auxiliary type, whatever the third one we are discussing, auxiliary type. So whenever water is received in this baby siphon, so this siphon, what happens, immediately it gives the water, it projects the water here and it is blocked the way. So water, whatever the air is there, that should not be entered here. So it will be filled with the water, whatever the cup is there, this will be filled with the water. Whenever this baby siphon receives water, it will be pumped here. Okay, so this is tudal type. So here you can see we are providing a step here like this, and this is one more type. So just above, this is here, below we are providing a step here, and it is at the top only we are providing the step. So this is one more type, adjustable plate. So here plate is adjusted, plate is provided, and this plate is adjusted according to the flow in the siphon canal. Okay, flexible tongue type, whenever we require it is moving up and down like this, whenever flow is there it is adjusting itself. Okay, next one is priming weir. So here extra portion is provided here, so whenever water hits like this directly, and after that it is, after filling this area, it is then moving towards the downward direction. Okay, so these are the different types of siphon spillways, and the next one is we have siphon spillway. In that we have second type, that is volute spillway, volute siphon spillway. This is a symbolic picture of a volute siphon spillway. So this is the dome at the upstream side, and this is your drum, and this is pillar, and whenever water is there, that is entering here and it is going like this. So it gives the action like whatever the volutes are there and plan of tunnel. So this will be rotating and it will be pumping the water at a constant rate. Okay, so this is a special type of siphon spillway which is designed in India by Ayer. It consists of a vertical barrel or shaft bent at the discharge end. So this is the bent at the discharge end. Okay, and opened out in the form of a funnel at the top. So a funnel is opened at the top and it is bent in the downward direction. So this is about siphon second type, volute siphon type. Okay, so that's all for today. We'll see in the next class.